David, this is Yoomi Naredi. I wanted to explain a few couple of things by video, as it would be better than the email I'm going to send you. Anyway, what I was talking, very importantly, it is before every race, it is that you tighten this bolt, you check that it's tighten, normally it should not move, and this one. But this one, if you look behind, is a counter bolt. And you need to tighten those bolts against each other. Don't tighten against the spacer. If not, the swing arm will not move, okay? So this, and this time to time, normally they are nil stock. As well, this to check that it's tightened. Normally it's locked tight. I put you some rubber as you requested, and I will give you some extra, and I will give you the eBay link as well in case you want to buy extra. Time to time, check this as well. The exhaust bolt, because you have a single bolt to hold the exhaust plus the spring, which that should be all right. What else to do is that sometimes, time to time, here, I don't know if you see where is my finger here, with a screwdriver to make sure you tighten a little bit the steering lock. What else? It is quite pretty important. Yes, the. I put back the bung on the forks, each side, and here this one sometimes is worth that you take out, because here behind this one you have a big nut with a spanner. We need a spanner of 19, I think. This is tighten the wheel, okay? That's where you take your wheel in and out. What you need to check as well, it is this one here who hold the brake stay. You see this one who hold the brake stay. Again, it should not move because it's a nil stop, but in case, look time to time. And this one here is a bit of DIY, but what can I do when you have to create your own spacer? You see the spacer on the front wheel? You absolutely need this washer. Between the spacer and this aluminium flask, you have a little washer, a stainless steel washer. It's very important, because my spacer, if not, will be touching the rubber seal on the bearings, and that's no good, okay? So the washer is slightly smaller to touch the center part. That's it, except that what I wanted to tell you, the speedo work, the tachometer, sorry, it's not a speedo. Time to time, I mean every race, you need to take this in and out. You see what I put here is a jack plug, it goes in. This is to save the energy, okay? So every time you stop to use the bike, you put it in. And the rev counter, the tachometer doesn't move. Every time you race, you put it out. If it comes empty or it doesn't react to the engine, it's simply that needed just a couple of hours charge with a 12 volt battery, and that's it, and it will come back. The tank is okay, the seat is okay, the shocks are okay. The rear brake, I am not sure if it's to your liking, but it works better now. The exhaust is lovely. I will do, of course, another video with the engine running, but I need help because I cannot do the video and ride the bike at the same time. So here is your new trumpet. The carburetor is quite a lot of new parts. We included the new flange here, absolutely very important. The engine now has been, the cylinder and the ports has been bored to 24 millimeter. That before used to have a bigger flange and a smaller intake, which is completely wrong. That's the reason it was not working properly. You have a 19 millimeter to 22 millimeter ports inlet and outlet, and you had a 28 millimeter Delorto, so something wrong. Anyway, all of this has been rectified with electronic ignition, etc. The bike starts and runs well, and I hope you like it. Thank you, bye bye.